Yes, this is another viewer question from Garland County. And this viewer says, we are one of four states that does not allow online voter registration. Should Arkansas have online voter registration? Mr. Womack.
Well, you know, I guess we should have online voter registration if there is a way to ensure that it's, as many people have said, easy to vote, hard to cheat. And that, I think, is where the rub is. I don't question anything about Arkansas election law at all. The elections in Arkansas in the last election, I thought, were executed perfectly. Were there a few hiccups in some places? I guess there always are. The real question is in the details. I think what most people want is I think they want to make sure that the people who are voting in our elections are qualified to vote in our elections. And that those votes are properly counted. And as long as we have a system in place that provides for that level of confidence, then I like exactly what we do in Arkansas and wish maybe and likely that the rest of the country would follow our lead.
Ms. Mallett Hayes.
We are in the 21st century and we should absolutely be able to online register. It is a shame that people have to go through so many steps to be able to get their vote to count here in the state of Arkansas. There is a system in place, like Mr. Womack was speaking of, because we had to use it to get out or to prevent us from receiving the child tax credit. You had to go in, put all this information, you had a system that you had to take your picture. That system is in place. We can easily transfer that into the state of Arkansas. We could transfer that into all the states to make sure that our elections are safe and that there is no questioning. I don't question at all that our elections were safe, but I definitely do not want to see another 2020 in the future elections. And if we can do that by creating easier to use systems that we can provide identification for people, then I'm all for it.
Mr. Kalagas.
In order to register, you have to show ID that you are who you say you are. You have to show proof of residency, like you've got an electric bill. You got to fill out a form. You can do that online just as easy as you can in person. You can scan an ID. You can scan an electric bill. You can fill out a form online. There's absolutely no reason why we shouldn't have online voter registration.
30 seconds for follow-up. Mr. Womack.
If it's a fail-safe program, I support it.
Ms. Mallett Hayes.
I think we've hit it all.
And Mr. Kalagas, you have another.
That one's pretty easy.
Okay, our next question, I believe, is from me, and it goes to Ms. Mallett Hayes. There apparently is there is legislation now pending, started over on the Senate side, to make nationwide a ban on abortion. This is, of course, following the reversal of Roe. Your position?
Honestly, I looked into this one a little bit. Being in a state right now where we have one of the most restrictive laws, I was kind of very intrigued to see if it would open up the access for women in the state of Arkansas. And unfortunately, it doesn't. So no, I would not support that legislation. We are setting a terrible precedent by not following the experts' opinions on what's best for females and women in their health care. And we're also telling half of the American population that we don't believe that they're capable of making an informed decision for themselves. On top of that, most of the legislators that are making these laws for us have no idea the mental, emotional, or physical toll that a pregnancy can take on a person.
Ms. Kalagas.
I firmly believe that at the point of conception, a unique new individual life is formed, and that unique person is entitled to all of the rights and all of the protections as every other person. So, personally, I don't have any children. My only child died 6 weeks after conception. And that is the most incredibly painful thing that I've ever endured and that I still endure. And I cannot imagine someone going up to someone who has lost a child like that and say, it was just a mass of cells. You've got nothing to grieve. So our courts have already ruled that we can use DNA to identify individual people. And at the point of conception, we have human DNA unique to an individual. It's not the mother, it's not the father. I think our laws need to reflect that. Are there times when someone is authorized to use deadly force against somebody? Yes, there are. And our courts can determine that, and we can determine that at trial. But at the point of conception, you have a unique human life. That life deserves just as much protection as everyone else's.
Mr. Womack, a statutory ban?
The Dobbs decision pushed it back to the states. And of course, in Arkansas, has already been discussed, we have a trigger law here, a trigger bill, or a trigger law that goes into effect pursuant to the Dobbs decision. I believe that on issues like this that are so close and so emotional and so emotionally charged, that the best place for those issues to be decided is where the people, closest to the people. That's the way our Constitution was formed. But that said, you know, I support a federal ban on abortions with certain exemptions, you know, certain exceptions. And I've been very clear about that. My pro-life record speaks for itself. But again, the closest we can get these decisions to the people that should decide them, I think, is best for all concerned. And we will see how this plays out in the coming weeks and months.
Follow up, Ms. Malatese.
Abortion has become this very politicized thing, but when we look at the root of what abortion actually is, it is a medical procedure that is warranted at times, and there is nobody that needs to make that decision besides a female and her medical providers. As a mother of two children that will be of childbearing age soon, I hope and I pray that they will always have the ability to make the best decision for them without interference from our government.
Mr. Kalagias.
Yeah, I think a lot of times we're having the wrong argument. This shouldn't be an argument over what medical procedures should or shouldn't be allowed. This is a rights argument. So should all people get equal protection of the law or not? So I believe everyone should get equal protection of the law. That includes our children.
Mr. Womack, 30 seconds.
Nothing else to add other than what I've already said. It's a tough issue. It's going to continue to be debated across our country. And we'll see what the next Congress does insofar as proposing abortion bans and where they play out.